Can you stay there? Thank you. Salut les amis, bienvenue et bon retour sur ma chaîne. Hola, bienvenue dans la ami canal. Konnichiwa, watashi no chaneru ni yukusu. Today we're gonna have another how to live it your personal style series. And today is all about the African swag. You know, swag. We swagging here, we dancing here. We're gonna have a lot of dancing happening on today, but I could be dancing, but it's not the point of this video, right? So let's talk about the personal style, let's talk about the confidence, let's talk about how you can inspire yourself from those styles and how you can make it your own through your own branding, through your own personality, and how you can show up with more confidence on video. That's all the point here when it comes to those episodes, I'm just saying. So we can talk about personal style. We're talking about personal style. Who's the girl? Like, who are you to talk about it? Well, let me tell you a bit about myself here. I'm Lady Tomo. I'm a psych coach and I'm dedicated, passionate about helping creative soul woman entrepreneur, just like you were watching at the moment, using the personal style as the best asset. Using the videos to be able to get their business to the next level in a much more authentic way. Style as style therapy for me, because it's all about the personal development linked to your own personal style. And I shared my story a couple of days ago, so if you want to know more about where I'm coming from with it, well, you gotta watch that video first to be able to understand all those little things that I'm sharing with you today. Talking about the African swag, it's dancing, it's a lot about the joy, it's a lot about the colorfulness part of it, it's a lot about owning your curves and owning your body in such a beautiful way. African women in general, they are really curvy. Way that my own mom, she has a tiny waist and I definitely took it from her. But when it comes to the butt area, it's much more bigger. And it's just the way it is in Africa. Coca-Cola bottles like that, where it's like super, super slim and then it go all the way down. This is the African body. Pride. We have a lot of pride when it comes to showing up those curves. Of course, it's always in such a much more sophisticated way, much more sexier. And I talked about the French culture because it's something that kind of inspired me a lot as well, because I used to live in multiple continents, multiple countries. But growing up in Africa, you kind of realize that you can own your body and have to accept your sexiness the way it is. Anything that could be even a bit fitted could show up as being really tacky just because you're much more curvier. Stereotypes, the society views of it, it's all in the mindset and the culture way of saying it. So now, when it comes to you owning your style and wanting to get some inspiration from any type of Africanness, first and foremost, think about the joy. Something that comes back a lot when it comes to African countries, because we might go through our own battles with a lot of things. Media makes it really, really, really bad than what it is in reality. Let me tell you that first. Go throughout your day, even with the most biggest challenge that a lot of people are facing in my own country or any other country in Africa. Make it something that I honestly respect a lot from us African people, because we don't see the bad in everything, even when everything is bad, you know? So the style, or the way that we see style, is a kind of reflection of that, and even more because of the colonization. History class here. We used to have tribes, and that's still the way it is right now. There was not necessarily the borders like the way it is now, where it's much more like the colonization that made it that way. Any country, camera, Senegal, Mali, Ivory Coast, they all are made up countries. Like French and Spanish and Portuguese kind of share the territory. Up until today, in Cameroon, you're gonna have at least 262 tribes. A lot of ethnical costume would reflect, others would have a meaning. Plus, you live in countries where there is sunlight almost every day. You know what I mean? So there is no winter. So I said it a lot in the tone. When you wear color, it's almost because it's gonna be a therapy for you. It doesn't have to be the rainbow. It really doesn't have to be the rainbow. But the fact that you have the sun, having that sunlight onto your face makes you feel a certain way. Let me know below. When we get to spring and how much we feel a lot better when we see the sunlight, when we see the trees going back to life, we feel like there's life happening out there, you know? The same thing when it goes to the colors that you're gonna have on you. We spend so many sunny days, we have that natural joy, and that's why it helps a lot even when everything else is challenging. Colors are just a reflection of our joie de vivre, like we can say in French. Or you can infuse that in your own wardrobe. So I try to be able to overcome anything really happening in your life. And right now, we're having a lot of challenging times. The virus, it's gonna be up to you to choose how you want to see it. Do you want to see it as something that you can never overcome? Or do you want to see it as a momentum for you to uncover your greatest gift and start your business? Because it's still possible. So using the joy to go towards something much more positive. That's a whole mindset behind every type of colorful outfit that you can see from African clothing in general. The first thing is to smile. Even when everything is bad, keep smiling. It's honestly something that's gonna help you a ton. If you want to cry right now and complain about everything happening, you losing the control over it. Control you have is on you. It's focusing on you. It's a big part of African culture and the joy and the dancing. Have fun. When it comes to showing up on video, we have that kind of straight to the bullet type of truth. Where we're not gonna disguise the truth, we're gonna say it the way it is, and sometimes it could be harsh. So you need to take it into consideration. It's not always gonna come from something bad. You need to be able to take a distance, saying that the way that I've been raised, I can tell you, when I did a lot of bad things, my mom was not gonna sugarcoat it. It can sound bad, but at the same time, you get the point right from the get-go. It's not another way to say, maybe she meant that, maybe I went not sure, no. The patterns, they're everything with us. Give us some patterns, give us some warm colors. We are living for it. So if you want to elevate your style and you feel like you want to inspire yourself from any type of African swag, you need to want to add up more colors to your wardrobe. If you're neutral, that might be much more complicated, which is fine, because I talked about the French culture. Everything too colorful, usually they are repelled by it. This is you not being afraid to do it if you want to do it. Usually it's gonna be the warm colors, because you live in Africa. Yeah, it's tropical, it's sunny, gonna go with the warm tones, go really well on us. The other thing is appearance does matter. Anything you're gonna do, it has to be sophisticated to the next level. Sophistication in a way that wherever you go, you need to dress up the part. Going to church, for example, every Sunday, like we used to do, not with jeans. No, it's not happening. Not like we're going to the wedding. You had to dress up. You had to put something dressy on you. It's not a question here. And it's a big part of the culture, because whatever you're gonna do, whatever you're gonna say, it's tied to your family name. Everything that people are gonna say about you, they're gonna say the same thing about your family. So if you do something bad in Cameroon, let's say, and people know your family, it's not gonna be you only that people are gonna blame. It's gonna be the whole family that people are gonna blame. So it's super important to represent your family in a certain way. People can see your status from the get-go. You can say whatever you want to say about it. Like I said, it's a way of living. Before, it's much more in the sexy way. Anything that could flatter your body. African women, they love to show off those. Oh, they adore it. The curvier they are, the happier they are, the happier they feel. And it's really interesting, because you go in Europe, it's like the total opposite. Cameroon specifically, I get to see a lot of my friends, and I grew up around that kind of body shape. So I never found it surprising for me to be skinny, still having the curves. I was like, well, really sexy, really cute, and you have to own it. The type of curvier or fitted shape, it's something that a lot of African women, they love. Sophisticated feminine, the better, the femme fatale. So any type of dark or rich color, the red, the gold, the black sometimes, the combination that we tend to love a lot. If again you have that sophisticated vibe and femme fatale type of look, you probably already love your heels. The higher they are, the better they are. Not for me anymore. When it comes to being on videos, you want to have rich or warm colors. You don't want to stay in something too casual. This is the vibe that you want to have if you want to inspire yourself from the African swag when it comes to your personal style. High pattern scarves, it's something that you can add to your own personal style. The dresses, the accessories, they don't need to be super big, because if they're too big and they're making noise, it's distracting. Anything that you're gonna do though, you're gonna do it in moderation. Don't do everything. Do not be afraid to say the things the way they are. Be honest, still being respectful though. And in the way that you're gonna convey your messaging to people watching your videos, they're gonna feel it. They're gonna feel it, and that's gonna be a part of your personality too. So if you get to hesitate into what you want to say, people can feel that, and people are gonna be scared if you are scared. If you don't agree about something, tell it the way it is. Still being respectful. Don't be afraid of having your own opinions. That's it for the day. I hope you liked it. I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know what was your favorite hack. Like I said, I don't want to go into too many pieces, so have much more so the mindset and how you can translate it to your own personality and your own branding. Type of other question you might have so that I can do a video on it. And for the time being, follow me on Instagram. I do a lot of confidence boosts and tips and IGTV videos as well, and how to style when I get to be inspired. Have my soul and style alignment coaching program right down below. Get to book your free discovery call, because it's much more so than having a capsule wardrobe. If you watch my video on my own story, you know where I'm coming from with it. Having a lot of fun with your style, but being able to uncover what is real and authentic about you, to be able to show the world your greatest gift, because you have it in you already. It's a whole guide onto how to be able to show up on videos with a lot of confidence, being able to connect with the right people for you. All of that is going to be down below. All the details are going to be down below. Be starting late April or beginning of May. No, not everybody is able to make it work, and I totally understand, and that's why I'm having monthly payment plans, because I want to make it really flexible for you. I'm gonna see you on my next video as usual. J'espère que vous avez aimé la vidéo, j'espère que vous avez adoré. Laissez-moi savoir c'est quoi votre astuce, ce que vous avez préféré le plus en fait. Ce que vous avez aimé, laissez-moi savoir. Puis bah, je vais vous revoir pour ma prochaine vidéo. I'm gonna see you for my next video. Like I say all the time, smile because it's free and contagious in a good way. Bye.